Students, now we can through a formula we can predict the hybridization as well as the shape of the molecule, right? So the formula to find out the hybridization of any species, for that we have to first find out the number of hybrid orbital on central atom. For that we have a formula, half v plus m minus c plus a. Now what is v? V stands here for number of valence electron on central atom. M stands for the number of monovalent atom surrounding central atom. C stands for the number of positive charge on cation. Similarly, A stands here for the number of unit of negative charge on anion. Right? So if we know the number of valence electron on central atom, if we know the number of monovalent means here those atoms which have got the valency 1. For example, we have hydrogen, all the halogens which have got the valency 1, they are counted as a monovalent atom. So we will, if they are present around the central atom, we will just get it mentioned. C stands for the cation. If the species is a positive charge, then what is the magnitude of the positive charge? We have to write it over here. And if it is a negative charge, it is anion A, then we have to write down the magnitude of it here. Right? Now we will try to solve it. Let's take an example here first of hydronium ion, H3O positive student here. So first of all, you will write the central atom, or you will find out the central atom, its oxygen here. So the number of hybrid orbital on oxygen is equal to how much student? For that we have to first know its valence electron. So what is the valence electron on oxygen? So it is total 6 electrons. So you will write down here 6. Then the number of monovalent, that is which have got the valency 1, it is how much? 1. It is of hydrogen, so we are having 3 hydrogen atom. So it is 1 into 3 minus. Is it a positive charge species? Yes, it is positive charge and it has got a magnitude of 1, and here it is coming 0. So here student, it will become 6 plus 3, 9, 9 minus 1. So it is coming half into 8, that is overall 4. So this species has got 4 sp3, 4 hybrid orbital, and which hybridization it is going to undergo, we will start with the S subshell. So it is S. So next comes the P. So how many orbitals are there maximum? It is 3. So this species undergo sp3 hybridization, and the expected shape student, it will be tetrahedral, right? So in this way you will predict the number on the hybridization just by calculating up the number of the hybrid orbital on the central atom. Now let's find out the hybridization of the IF5. So you of this species. We have to find out the hybridization of this species. So for that, you will first calculate out the number of hybrid orbital on iodine. So you know that iodine, it is a halogen, and all the halogens have the valence electron 7, right? The monovalent around it is fluorine, and it is 5 fluorine atom. Since it is a neutral charge species, there is no positive charge as well as no negative charge. So it is coming 7 plus 5, 12, 6. So the overall we have got 6 hybrid orbital. So we will try to name this, get this number of hybrid orbitals into the hybridization formula, which kind of hybridization it is going to show. So we will begin with S, since we have got only one S option, S orbital, so it is S, P, 3, D, 2, 5 and 6. So it is S, P, 3, D, 2 hybridization. Right, students? So IF5 will undergo the sp3d2 hybridization, and the expected shape is octahedral. So I will be just sending you the table where the hybridization along with its shape will be given to you, so that it will become easier for you to predict it, right? So you will practice this and you will try to find out the hybridization of different molecules. Now let's find out the hybridization of NO3 negative molecule species. Here the central atom is nitrogen. So again, the same formula you will apply, number of hybrid orbital equals to half V plus N. So what is the valence electron on nitrogen atom, student? It is 5 plus number of monovalent, no monovalent here, minus cation. It is not a positive charge species, so we put here 0, and the anion it is 1, unit of negative charge is there, so it will be 5 plus 1, 6, so it's coming 3. So number of hybrid orbital is 3. So the expected hybridization is going to be, we will start with S, it will be sp2. So the given species NO3 negative will undergo the sp2 hybridization, and the expected shape of the molecule. So you know that sp2 shows the trigonal planar or trigonal planar geometry, right, students? So this is about the, we have discussed the positive species, negative species, right, as well as the neutral species also, to find out the hybridization. So you will just try to find out the hybridization of ClF3 molecule, right? So let's do number of hybrid orbital here is on chlorine, surrounding the chlorine atom is half, it is 7 is the valence electron, fluorine number of monovalent is 3 here, minus no cation, no anion, so 0. So it is coming how much, students? 7 plus 3, 10, it is 5. So the hybridization expected is sp3, and it is D, right? sp3D hybridization. So the sp3 hybridization expected shape is trigonal bipyramidal. But due to the presence of the two lone pair, right, the shape gets distorted to T shape. So the actual shape is T shape, right? So, but then since it is sp3d hybridization, it will undergo the sp3 hybridization will have the expected shape to be trigonal bipyramidal, and due to presence of the two lone pair on the chlorine atom, the repulsion will take place. And to get the stability, it will get a T-shape.